The heavy downpours that followed a long dry spell came at midnight on Saturday and returned the following day with devastating effects. The Katewa family of six were left without a roof over their head after it was completely blown off by strong wind, as Pius Katewa explains.
Time we just reached the sitting room, the thunder shower started. It's a heavy wind with a heavy rain. A thunder shower come on same time. I just see a black things. From there, just fire only. Same time I see a fire, I was sorted my house is start burning. Then the roof the same time the thunder shower started. My whole roof is gone.
Edward Makanga's family of five also felt the wrath of nature when a tree uprooted by the thunderstorm flattened their shack. One member of the family is recovering in the Rundu State Hospital from neck and shoulder injuries after they had to rescue her from the rubble.
And then I could feel that the rain was heavy and it was the strong wind was also coming. And then I happened to wake up and then see, because the water was entering the room through the thing, on top of the thing. Then I wanted to check now whether the kids are sleeping comfortable or not. So just when I wake up, I just feel a sound quite like a bomb. And then from there, I can see that on the other side where the kids were sleeping, it was a bit fine. But where I left my girlfriend, the other one, it was just dark. And then from there, I have to turn, fight, just to go under the thing and then try to lift them up. Where I tried to call, because she was just quiet. I thought she was dead, but when I tried to call the name, she was answering. So at least I lift up the zinc, and then her sister was also coming to help me. Then we pull her out. And then later on, she was taken to the hospital, but she's having a neck injury.
Chief Alphonse Kaundo of the Mbunza Traditional Authority, a relative of the Makanga family, was also at the scene to witness the damage caused by the torrents. Both families suffered heavy losses to property and clothes, especially children's uniforms, and are now appealing for assistance from the public that could help them rebuild their lives. A new service station at the town Kavango Petrol Port was not spared either, as its parking area was battered to the ground by the rainy storm.